Hey everyone, it's Apsaline, and today I'll be finally opening my shop. So this video is sponsored by Wix, which, as you all know, is a wonderful website building platform with a variety of widgets, templates, and code editing capability. I'll be adding a shop to my Wix website utilizing their Wix Stores features. I know a ton of you guys have been asking about a shop to sell prints, stickers, and all other kinds of fun stuff. Opening up a nice shop as an artist is important because you get to learn different things, such as trade skills like commerce and having another revenue source, and you get to learn about your audience a little better as well. As you all know, these uncertain times halted a majority of public events that includes conventions. I was gonna delve into the world of conventions starting in 2020, and I was really excited, and then all this stuff happened and basically everything went sideways and hit my finances pretty hard. So I'll be starting out by selling old print stock for an affordable price and eventually follow that up with like stickers and charms, and I'm just really excited to get stuff out to you guys. I also have a ton of other things up my sleeve for my shop. If it goes well, I'll be revealing some pretty cool items to you guys in the near future. So starting off, I went ahead to Wix.com, signed into my Wix account, and clicked edit my site. You can make an online store from scratch by using a store template, but I decided to tack my store onto my main website, apsaline.net. I went ahead and added Wix stores by going to the sidebar add button, which is a little plus sign, going down to stores and clicking add a store. Clicking add a store basically provides a customizable and workable store template in a gallery form with built-in and editable navigation. The first thing I did, even before editing, was create clean and inviting mockup so viewers can see the product clearly. Thankfully, Wix's image previews are very high quality and provide crisp thumbnails to display my products. I noticed in the beginning the amount of widgets and things that can be added to a site, and I immediately got excited. The store will pop up on your site as a clickable gallery displaying all of the prices and the titles of your products. So I went ahead and added all of my products before editing anything, which took the longest in the process, but it's very important to be accurate with things like these. In order to add a product, you start by clicking add product and uploading an image. The great thing is Wix allows you to upload multiple images of your product. Then you can change the title, the price, the description, and I also added the amount of each product I had. Wix allows you to add so much information to a product, like price, stock, variations, and basically different info fields, so you can display your shipping policies and your return policies and all that good stuff. You can even add tags to the thumbnails to show if something is on sale or limited edition. In order to keep the same info throughout, I duplicated one listing and then used it as a base, tweaking the info for each product as I went along. Wix also allows you to make collections, which are a good way to organize your site. So this will be my print collection. When I add more stuff to my shop, like stickers, I'll be sure to add a sticker collection, and then more navigation for a more comprehensive product selection. You're also allowed to edit every navigational page, like the shop page, checkout page, and order page. I suggest putting a cart on every page, so it's easy for people on your site to get back and forth while shopping. You can do this by going to the sidebar, clicking the add button, heading down to store, clicking shopping cart, and adding it to your pages. And of course, you can change the look of the cart to fit your taste. I also, of course, added one of my little GIF assets to keep my entire site cohesive by going to the sidebar, clicking add, going to images and my image uploads, found an unused GIF from the first time I edited my website, and added it to my store page. Wix allows you to drag and drop its features and provide you with snapping and guides, and it basically makes for a more professional, clean look so nothing really looks out of place. I really wanted to add a pop-up element to my homepage to let people know that my shop was open. After browsing around, I found an interactive element called a lightbox, which can allow you to add pop-up things like discounts or site welcomes, and you can basically be really creative with that. To add a lightbox to my site, I went to the plus button and found interactive. In interactive, there's a bunch of cool things like hover boxes, slideshows, and of course, lightboxes. To add a lightbox, I looked through the examples and found what was best for me. Everything is super editable, so you don't have to worry about using a pre-made template. I went ahead and added it by clicking it and changed the background photo along with the messages I wanted to display. You can also drag it to any place on your site, edit the delay and hover effects. To be honest, Wix provides so many options to build a great shop that it was like a playground for me. And of course, if you're interested in even more in-depth website building, Wix provides a code editing tool called Velo. So it's useful for beginners or for people who are developers and programmers and know your way around code. To utilize Velo, you go up to the top bar and find Dev Mode. Click it and you'll be able to toggle it on or off, adding an extra layer of in-depth editing capability. While opening my shop, I decided to provide a free random print with every order. So in order to display that correctly, I browsed around for a graphic to suit me best. I eventually found a photo strip widget, which I added by going all the way to the sidebar, clicking the add plus sign, and finding strip all the way at the top. I browsed around to find one to suit me best, and then added it to my site by clicking it. Then I went ahead and changed the background to an image of a pile or a collection of my prints. When I went to the settings of the strip, I noticed you can also add like cool scrolling effects. So I added this really cool parallax scrolling effect, which you guys should totally check out because it looks awesome. So then I went ahead and edited the mobile site, which is very important. You can also edit your main site and your mobile site back and forth. So it's like a really comprehensive way of making sure everything looks professional and like cohesive. But don't forget to edit your mobile site so that it's accessible to everyone. Wix also gives you all the options you need when it comes to shipping providers. In order to set up your shipping, go to the sidebar and find the shopping bag icon. Click the store manager and select edit shipping rules. This should take you to the dashboard settings under shipping and fulfillment. There you can edit the info for your domestic shipping and international shipping if you choose to do so. After that, you can go into each shipping section and edit the details like your services, how many days it'll take for it to get there, and what kind of mail you'll be sending. You can also edit your package type and backup settings just in case something goes wrong with calculations of the shipping. Wix has a bunch of different options for choosing a shipping provider and shipping method, so be sure to choose whichever option is most accessible to you. I also had to have a way to make sure that people could pay for my shop. First, head to the sidebar and click the shopping bag icon again that represents your store manager. Here, you can click Update Your Payment Methods. With Wix Payments, you can link your PayPal account as well as your bank account by putting in your information and setting up a revenue source safely and securely. There are also other payment options that can be set up, such as Afterpay, Square Point of Sale, Stripe, and other providers. Before you can start taking online orders, you must upgrade your Wix website to one of three e-commerce plans. In order to do that, go to the Wix homepage and click Manage Plan. There will be a button with three dots. Click that and then click Upgrade Plan. There you can move from website plans to business and e-commerce plans. Each plan provides a different amount of space for your site as well as different website features. After all that is set up, then you can access your Wix dashboard by going to the sidebar and clicking the shopping bag. Under Run Your Store, click Go to Dashboard. There you're able to access many things for your store, such as products, orders, customer management, marketing, analytics, and finances, which show your payouts and other things. I also love how my store turned out, and I highly recommend trying Wix's builder and e-commerce platform. I feel like with Wix, plus your creativity and branding, you're guaranteed a professional outcome. So yeah, that's how I built my store, and I hope you're all excited to see what I have planned for it in the upcoming months. The link to my store is in the description, and I literally cannot wait to start packaging and shipping orders for you guys. If you're interested in building a website or opening a store with Wix, please go to wix.com/apseline store. And be sure to go ahead and check out my store at apseline.net/shop. It's my first time running a store, so I'd hope to have you guys' support. Be sure to swing by and check out some of my prints. Thank you all for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye!